Let's take a in-depth review on Mammoth, the Goessler wooden coaster in Tripsted. So first up, I'm going to talk about what I think about the coaster, and then some stats, and talk over a point of view, give you my top 5 elements, and last but not least, I will figure out a final score out of 10. So, Mammoth is, like I said just before, really interesting, a Goessler wooden coaster. So, I believe this is the only one of them. I know some woodies have the train of a Goessler, like for example Falken at Forbes Summerland. But yeah, it's 30 meters tall, it is 860 meters long, and it goes 90 kilometers an hour. So the stats is actually decent. But it is pretty tame in my opinion. It doesn't really do a whole lot, and the layout looks like it should have been going on maybe 5 or 10 meters taller. Because then it will improve the speed, and then it will have some laterals and some airtime. It doesn't really. So yeah, it first up, it goes through that little dark ride section. I don't know exactly what this ride is themed to. Kind of just a wood factory, I think. It's kind of weird, but I kind of like the theming. Yeah, everything just goes crazy here. They got some smoke out, and I think this is a great start. I actually like this little dark ride section a lot. Then the lift hill is actually also really nice, because this coaster has some beautiful soundtrack and audio going up this lift hill, and you have a beautiful view of Tripsted. Then going down the first drop, which wasn't as impressive as I expected it to be. I thought it looks like a great drop. I rode it once in the back and once in the front, and obviously the back drop was much, much better. But the front, yeah, was tame. The back was, yeah, it has a little bit of some fun laterals. The turns is taken by, yeah, little to no speed, so therefore you don't get any laterals. On all the airtime hills, I would say that in the front row, you get some slight floater. In the back, you get nothing at all. One thing I have to mention about this is it's actually really smooth. It was a little bit bumpy, not quite as smooth as some people say it is. This tunnel here is, by the way, really fun, because you can't really see what is happening, and there's a transition in there. So yeah, top 5 elements on Mammoth. Yeah, number 5, I have this floater airtime hill. It is the best one of all the airtime hills, in my opinion. It's the second one to come, but it is really underwhelming to go over an airtime hill and just get a slight little puff of just weak floater. Number 4, yeah, I have the lift hill. I know this is so weird, but beautiful audio and a beautiful view of Tripsted. At number 3 spot, I have the drop, which is a fun drop, but it wasn't as good as I expected it to be. I thought it would be, yeah, it looks like something like Troy at Toverland, just not quite as twisty. So just think I expected more than it clearly turned out to be. At number 2 spot, I have this little dark ride section. This was a pleasantly surprise. I mean, it's one of the better dark ride pre-show things you have in coasters, in my opinion. The smoke, the light effects, the sound, just make it. And yeah, it's an awesome start to this fun little ride. At number 1, I do have the tunnel. Yeah, this is no doubt the best element of this ride for me. It has a transition in there, and that gives some slight laterals as the only thing, and just surprising and fun. Now to a final conclusion of this video. So Mammoth is decently fun, but I find it quite underwhelming, sadly. I know it is a family coaster, but a family coaster doesn't have to be boring. Look at Juvenil, Dew of Summerland, Polar Explorer, Rutschebanen, Tivoli Gardens, 13 Alton Towers, Wickerman Alton Towers. But there's a lot of great family coasters out there, and Mammoth is just not one of the greatest ones, in my opinion. So for a final score, I can't go higher than 3.5 out of 10. Yeah, I actually thought I was going to make a review of Helix, maybe Carajo before this one, maybe El Toro. But I thought, you know what, Mammoth is a coaster that nobody talks about. So now I just wanted to give you my personal thoughts about Mammoth. So that has been it. I hope you enjoyed this review. Bye guys.